Cinema of Japan, that has a history that spans more than 100 years. Japan has one of the oldest and largest film industries in the world. As of 2010, it was the fourth largest by number of feature films produced. In 2011, Japan produced 411 feature films that earned 54.9% of a box office total of $2.338 billion. Movies have been produced in Japan since 1897, when the first foreign cameramen arrived. In a sight and sound list of the best films produced in Asia, Japanese works made up 8 of the top 12, with Tokyo Story, 1953, ranked number 1. Japan has won the Academy Award for the Best Foreign Language Film 4 times, more than any other Asian country. The kinetoscope, first shown commercially by Thomas Edison in the United States in 1894, was first shown in Japan in November 1896. The Vitascope and the Lumière Brothers Cinematograph were first presented in Japan in early 1897, by businessmen such as Inabata Katsutaro. Lumière cameramen were the first to shoot films in Japan. Moving pictures, however, were not an entirely new experience for the Japanese because of the rich tradition of pre-cinematic devices such as gentō, utsushi-e, or the magic lantern. The first successful Japanese film in late 1897 showed sights in Tokyo. In 1898, some ghost films were made: the Shiro Asano shorts Bake Jizo, Jizo the Spook Slash, and Shinen no Sase, Resurrection of a Corpse. The first documentary, the short Geisha no Teodori, was made in June 1899. Tsunekichi Shibata made a number of early films, including Mamajigari, an 1899 record of two famous actors performing a scene from a well-known kabuki play. Early films were influenced by traditional theater, for example, kabuki and bunraku. At the dawn of the 20th century, theaters in Japan hired benchi, storytellers who sat next to the screen and narrated silent movies. They were descendants of kabuki jorori, koden storytellers, theater barkers, and other forms of oral storytelling. Benchi could be accompanied by music like silent films from cinema of the West. With the advent of sound in the early 1930s, the benchi gradually declined. In 1908, S.H. Ozio Makino, considered the pioneering director of Japanese film, began his influential career with Honnoji Gassen, produced for Yokota Shokai. S.H. Ozio recruited Matsuno Sukonoe, a former kabuki actor, to star in his productions. Onoe became Japan's first film star, appearing in over 1,000 films, mostly shorts, between 1909 and 1926. The pair pioneered the jidaigeki genre. Tokihiko Okada was a popular romantic lead of the same era. The first Japanese film production studio was built in 1909 by the Yoshizawa Shoden Company in Tokyo. The first female Japanese performer to appear in a film professionally was the dancer/actress Tokuko Nagai Takagi, who appeared in 4 shorts for the American-based Thanhouser Company between 1911 and 1914. Among intellectuals, critiques of Japanese cinema grew in the 1910s and eventually developed into a movement that transformed Japanese film. Film criticism began with early film magazines such as Katsudo Shashinkai, begun in 1909, and a full-length book written by Yasuno Sukganda in 1914. But many early film critics often focused on chastising the work of studios like Nikkatsu and Tenkatsu for being too theatrical, using, for instance, elements from kabuki and shinpa such as anagata, and for not utilizing what were considered more cinematic techniques to tell stories, instead relying on benchi. In what was later named the pure film movement, writers in magazines such as Kinema Record called for a broader use of such cinematic techniques. Some of these critics, such as Norimasa Kariyama, went on to put their ideas into practice by directing such films as The Glow of Life, 1918, which was one of the first films to use actresses, in this case, Arumi Hanayagi. There were parallel efforts elsewhere in the film industry. In his 1917 film The Captain's Daughter, Masao Inoue started using techniques new to the silent film era, such as the close-up and cutback. The pure film movement was central in the development of the jidaigeki and scriptwriting. New studios established around 1920, such as Shochiku and Taikatsu, aided the cause for reform. At Taikatsu, Thomas Kurihara directed films scripted by the novelist Junichiro Tanizaki, who was a strong advocate of film reform. Even Nikkatsu produced reformist films under the direction of Eizo Tanaka. By the mid-1920s, actresses had replaced anagata and films used more of the devices pioneered by Inoue. Some of the most discussed silent films from Japan are those of Kenji Mizoguchi, whose later works, for example, The Life of Oharu, are still highly regarded. Japanese films gained popularity in the mid-1920s against foreign films, in part fueled by the popularity of movie stars and a new style of jidaigeki. Directors such as Daisuke Ito and Masahiro Makino made samurai films like A Diary of Shuji's Travels and Ramengai, featuring rebellious anti-heroes in fast-cut fight scenes that were both critically acclaimed and commercial successes. Some stars, such as Tsumasaburo Bando, Kanjuro Arashi, Chizo Kataoka, Takako Iri, and Utami Ichikawa, were inspired by Makino film productions and formed their own independent production companies, where directors such as Hiroshi Inagaki, Mansaku Itami, and Sadao Yamanaka honed their skills. Director Tanosuke Kainugasa created a production company to produce the experimental masterpiece A Page of Madness, starring Misao Inoue, in 1926. Many of these companies, while surviving during the silent era against major studios like Nikitsu, Shochiku, Tekken, and Owa Studios, could not survive the cost involved in converting to sound. With the rise of left-wing political movements and labor unions at the end of the 1920s arose so-called tendency films with left-wing tendencies, with prominent examples being directed by Kenji Mizoguchi, Daisuke Ito, Shigeyoshi Suzuki, and Tomu Uchida. In contrast with these commercially produced 35mm films, the Marxist Proletarian Film League of Japan, Prokino, made works independently in smaller gauges, such as 9.5mm and 16mm, with more radical intentions. Tendency films suffered from severe censorship heading into the 1930s, and Prokino members were arrested and the movement effectively crushed. Such moves by the government had profound effects on the expression of political dissent in 1930s cinema. Films from this period include Sakunai Honda, Jitsuro Kuchushingura, Hareijima, Orochi, Mabroshi, Kurata Ipiji, Jujiro, and Kurama Tenku. A later version of The Captain's Daughter was one of the first talkie films. It used the Minnetalkie system. The Japanese film industry later split into two groups. One retained the Minnetalkie system, while the other used the Fushitofine talkie system used to make Tojo Masaki's films. The 1923 earthquake, the bombing of Tokyo during World War II, and the natural effects of time in Japan's humidity on inflammable and unstable nitrate film have resulted in a great dearth of surviving films from this period. Unlike in the West, silent films were still being produced in Japan well into the 1930s. A few Japanese sound shorts were made in the 1920s and 1930s, but Japan's first feature-length talkie was Fujiwara Yoshi no Furusato, 1930, which used the Minnetalkie system. Notable talkies of this period include Mikio Naruse's Wife, Be Like a Rose, Tsumi Yobara no Yoni, 1935, which was one of the first Japanese films to gain a theatrical release in the U.S., Yasujiro Ozu's An Inn in Tokyo, considered a precursor to the neorealism genre, Kenji Mizoguchi's Sisters of the Gion, Jinoshimai, 1936, Osaka Elegy, 1936, and The Story of the Last Chrysanthemums, 1939. And Sadao Yamanaka's Humanity and Paper Balloons, 1937. Film criticism shared this vitality, with many film journals such as Kinema Junpo and newspapers printing detailed discussions of the cinema of the day, both at home and abroad. A cultured impressionist criticism pursued by critics such as Tadashi Ijima, Fuyuiko Kitagawa, and Matsuo Kishi was dominant, but opposed by leftist critics such as Akira Iwasaki and Jinji Sasa, who sought an ideological critique of films. The 1930s also saw increased government involvement in cinema, which was symbolized by the passing of the film law, which gave the state more authority over the film industry, in 1939. The government encouraged some forms of cinema, producing propaganda films and promoting documentary films, also called bunka eiga or culture films, with important documentaries being made by directors such as Fumio Kami. Realism was in favor. Film theorists such as Taihei Imamura and Hayachi Sugiyama advocated for documentary or realist drama, while directors such as Hiroshi Shimizu and Tomotaka Tasaka produced fiction films that were strongly realistic in style. Because of World War II and the weak economy, unemployment became widespread in Japan, and the cinema industry suffered. During this period, when Japan was expanding its empire, the Japanese government saw cinema as a propaganda tool to show the glory and invincibility of Empire of Japan. Thus, many films from this period depict patriotic and militaristic themes. In 1942, Kajiro Yamamoto's film Hawaii Maroki Kaisen, or The War at Sea from Hawaii to Malaya, portrayed the attack on Pearl Harbor. The film made use of special effects directed by Eiji Tsuburaya, including a miniature-scale model of Pearl Harbor itself. Akira Kurosawa made his feature film debut with Sagata Sanshiro in 1943. The first collaborations between Kurosawa and actor Toshiro Mifune were Drunken Angel in 1948 and Stray Dog in 1949. Yasujiro Oza directed the critically and commercially successful Late Spring in 1949. The Mainichi Film Award was created in 1946. With the SCAP occupation following the end of World War II, Japan was exposed to over a decade's worth of American animation that had been banned under wartime government. The 1950s are widely considered the golden age of Japanese cinema. Three Japanese films from this decade, Rashomon, Seven Samurai and Tokyo Story, appeared in the top 10 of Sight and Sound's critics and directors polls for the best films of all time in 2002. They also appeared in the 2012 polls, with Tokyo Story, 1953, dethroning Citizen Kane at the top of the 2012 Directors Poll. The period after the American occupation led to a rise in diversity in movie distribution thanks to the increased output and popularity of the film studios of Toho, Dai, Shochiku, Nikkatsu, and Toei. This period gave rise to the four great artists of Japanese cinema: Masaki Kobayashi, Akira Kurosawa, Kenji Mizoguchi, and Yasujiro Ozu. Each director dealt with the effects of the war and subsequent occupation by America in unique and innovative ways. The decade started with Akira Kurosawa's Rashomon, 1950, which won the Golden Lion at the Venice Film Festival in 1951 and the Academy Honorary Award for Best Foreign Language Film in 1952, and marked the entrance of Japanese cinema onto the world stage. It was also the breakout role for legendary star Toshiro Mifune. In 1953, Intatsu no Mirabasho by Hinosuke Gosho was in competition at the 3rd Berlin International Film Festival. The first Japanese film in color was Carmen Comes Home, directed by Keisuke Kinoshita and released in 1951. There was also a black-and-white version of Eyes film available. Tokyo File 212, 1951, was the first American feature film to be shot entirely in Japan. The lead roles were played by Florence Marley and Robert Peyton. It featured the geisha Ichimaru in a short cameo. Suzuki Ikuzo's Tonichi Enterprises Company co-produced the film. Gate of Hell, a 1953 film by Tanosuke Kainugasa, was the first movie that filmed using Eastman color film. Gate of Hell was both Dai's first color film and the first Japanese color movie to be released outside Japan, receiving an Academy Honorary Award in 1954 for Best Costume Design by Sanzo Wada and an Honorary Award for Best Foreign Language Film. It also won the Palme d'Or at the Cannes Film Festival, the first Japanese film to achieve that honor. The year 1954 saw two of Japan's most influential films released. The first was the Kurosawa epic Seven Samurai, about a band of hired samurai who protect a helpless village from a rapacious gang of thieves. The same year, Ishiro Honda directed the anti-nuclear monster drama Godzilla, which was released in America as Godzilla, King of the Monsters. Though edited for its Western release, Godzilla became an international icon of Japan and spawned an entire subgenre of kaiju films, as well as the longest-running film franchise in history. Also in 1954, another Kurosawa film, Ikiru, was in competition at the 4th Berlin International Film Festival. In 1955, Hiroshi Inagaki won an Academy Honorary Award for Best Foreign Language Film for of his Samurai Trilogy, and in 1958 won the Golden Lion at the Venice Film Festival for Rickshaw Man. Kanichikawa directed two anti-war dramas, The Burmese Harp, 1956, which was nominated for Best Foreign Language Film at the Academy Awards, and Fires on the Plain, 1959, along with Incho, 1958, which was adapted from Yukio Mishima's novel Temple of the Golden Pavilion. Masaki Kobayashi made three films which would collectively become known as the Human Condition Trilogy: No Greater Love, 1959, and The Road to Eternity, 1959. The trilogy was completed in 1961, with A Soldier's Prayer. Kenji Mizoguchi, who died in 1956, ended his career with a series of masterpieces including The Life of Oharu, 1952, Ugetsu, 1953, and Sancho the Bailiff, 1954. He won the Silver Bear at the Venice Film Festival for Ugetsu. Mizoguchi's films often deal with the tragedies inflicted on women by Japanese society. Mikio Naru's Maidry Past, 1950, Late Chrysanthemums, 1954, The Sound of the Mountain, 1954, and Floating Clouds, 1955. Yasujiro Ozu began directing color films beginning with Equinox Flower, 1958, and later Good Morning, 1959, and Floating Weeds, 1958, which was adapted from his earlier silent A Story of Floating Weeds, 1934, and was shot by Rashomon and Sancho the bailiff cinematographer Kazuo Miyagawa. The Blue Ribbon Awards were established in 1950. The first winner for Best Film was Until We Meet Again by Tadashi Amai. The number of films produced and the cinema audience reached a peak in the 1960s. Most films were shown in double bills, with one half of the bill being a program picture or B-movie. A typical program picture was shot in 4 weeks. The demand for these program pictures in quantity meant the growth of film series such as The Hoodlum Soldier or Akumyo. The huge level of activity of 1960s Japanese cinema also resulted in many classics. Akira Kurosawa directed the 1961 classic Yojimbo. Yasujiro Ozu made his final film, An Autumn Afternoon, in 1962. Mikio Naru's directed the widescreen melodrama When a Woman Ascends the Stairs in 1960. His final film was 1967's Scattered Clouds. Kanichikawa captured the watershed 1964 Olympics in his 3-hour documentary Tokyo Olympiad, 1965. Seijun Suzuki was fired by Nikitsu for making films that don't make any sense and don't make any money after his surrealist Yakuza flick Branded to Kill, 1967. The 1960s were the peak years of the Japanese New Wave movement, which began in the 1950s and continued through the early 1970s. Nagisa Oshima, Kaneto Shindo, Masahiro Shinoda, Susumu Hani and Shohei Imamura emerged as major filmmakers during the decade. Oshima's Cruel Story of Youth, Night and Fog in Japan and Death by Hanging, along with Shindo's Onibaba, Hani's Kanojo to Care and Imamura's The Insect Woman, became some of the better-known examples of Japanese New Wave filmmaking. Documentary played a crucial role in the New Wave, as directors such as Hani, Kazuo Kuroki, Toshio Matsumoto, and Hiroshi Teshigahara moved from documentary into fiction film, while feature filmmakers like Oshima and Imamura also made documentaries. Shinsuke Ogawa and Noriaki Tsushimoto became the most important documentarists, two figures that tower over the landscape of Japanese documentary. Teshigahara's Woman in the Dunes, 1964, won a special jury prize at the Cannes Film Festival, and was nominated for Best Director and Best Foreign Language Film Oscars. Masaki Kobayashi's Kaidan, 1965, also picked up the special jury prize at Cannes and received a nomination for Best Foreign Language Film at the Academy Awards. Bushido, Samurai Saga by Tadashi Amai won the Golden Bear at the 13th Berlin International Film Festival. Immortal Love by Keisuke Kinoshita and Twin Sisters of Kyoto and Portrait of Chieko, both by Noboru Nakamura, also received nominations for Best Foreign Language Film at the Academy Awards. Lost Spring, also by Nakamura, was in competition for the Golden Bear at the 17th Berlin International Film Festival. The 1970s saw the cinema audience drop due to the spread of television. Total audience declined from 1.2 billion in 1960 to 0.2 billion in 1980. Film companies fought back in various ways, such as the bigger budget films of Kadokawa Pictures, or including increasingly sexual or violent content and language which could not be shown on television. The resulting pink film industry became the stepping stone for many young independent filmmakers. The 70s also saw the start of the Idol Era, films starring young idols, who would bring in audiences due to their fame and popularity. Toshio Fujita made the revenge film Lady Snowblood in 1973. In the same year, Yoshishichi Yoshida made the film Coup d'état, a portrait of Ikikita, the leader of the Japanese coup of February 1936. Its experimental cinematography and mise-en-scène, as well as its avant-garde score by Ishii Nagise, garnered it wide critical acclaim within Japan. In 1976 the Hōchi Film Award was created. The first winner for Best Film was The Inugamis by Kanichikawa. Nagisa Oshima directed In the Realm of the Senses, 1976, a film detailing a crime of passion involving Sada Abe set in the 1930s. Controversial for its explicit sexual content, it has never been seen uncensored in Japan. Kinji Fukasaku completed the epic battles without honor and humanity series of Yakuza films. Yoji Yamada introduced the commercially successful Tora-san series, while also directing other films, notably the popular The Yellow Handkerchief, which won the first Japan Academy Prize for Best Film in 1978. New wave filmmakers Susumu Honey and Shohei Imamura retreated to documentary work, though Imamura made a dramatic return to feature filmmaking with Vengeance Is Mine, 1979. Tedesco Den by Akira Kurosawa and Sandokan No. 8 by Keiko Mai were nominated to the Academy Award for Best Foreign Language Film. The 1980s saw the decline of the major Japanese film studios and their associated chains of cinemas, with major studios Toho and Toei barely staying in business, Shochiku supported almost solely by the Otokawatsurai films, and Nikkatsu declining even further. Of the older generation of directors, Akira Kurosawa directed Kagemusha, 1980, which won the Palme d'Or at the 1980 Cannes Film Festival, and Ran, 1985. Seijin Suzuki made a comeback beginning with Tsigoinerweisen in 1980. Shohei Imamura won the Palme d'Or at the Cannes Film Festival for The Ballad of Narayama, 1983. Yoshishichi Yoshida made A Promise, 1986, his first film since 1973's Coup d'État. New directors who appeared in the 80s include actor Juzo Itami, who directed his first film, The Funeral, in 1984, and achieved critical and box office success with Tampopo in 1985. Kiyoshi Kurosawa, who would generate international attention beginning in the mid-1990s, made his initial debut with pink films and genre horror. During the 1980s, anime gained in popularity, with new animated movies released every summer and winter, often based upon popular anime television series. Mamoru Oshii released his landmark Angel's Egg in 1983. Hayao Miyazaki adapted his manga series Nausicaä of the Valley of Wind into a feature film of same name in 1984. Katsuhiro Otomo followed suit by adapting his own manga Akira into a feature film of the same name in 1988. Home video made possible the creation of a direct-to-video film industry. Because of economic recessions, the number of movie theaters in Japan had been steadily decreasing since the 1960s. The 1990s saw the reversal of this trend and the introduction of the multiplex in Japan. Takeshi Kitano emerged as a significant filmmaker with works such as Sonatine, 1993, Kids Return, 1996, and Hinabi, 1997, which was given the Golden Lion of the Venice Film Festival. Shohei Imamura again won the Golden Palm, shared with Iranian director Abbas Kiarostami, this time for The Eel, 1997. He became the fifth two-time recipient, joining Alf Sjöberg, Francis Ford Coppola, Emir Kusturica, and Bill August. Kiyoshi Kurosawa gained international recognition following the release of Cure, 1997. Takashi Miike launched a prolific career with titles such as Audition, 1999, Dead or Alive, 1999, and The Bird People in China, 1998. Former documentary filmmaker Hirokazu Koreeda launched an acclaimed feature career with Maburoshi, 1996, and Afterlife, 1999. Hayao Miyazaki directed two mammoth box office and critical successes, Porco Rosso, 1992, which beat E.T. the Extraterrestrial, 1982, as the highest-grossing film in Japan, and Princess Mononoke, 1997. Which also claimed the top box office spot until Titanic, 1997. Several new anime directors rose to widespread recognition, bringing with them notions of anime as not only entertainment, but modern art. Mamoru Oshii released the internationally acclaimed philosophical science fiction action film Ghost in the Shell in 1996. Satoshi Kon directed the award-winning psychological thriller Perfect Blue. Hideaki Anno also gained considerable recognition with The End of Evangelion in 1997. The number of movies being shown in Japan steadily increased, with about 821 films released in 2006. Movies based on Japanese television series were especially popular during this period. Anime films now accounted for 60% of Japanese film production. The 1990s and 2000s are considered to be Japanese cinema's second golden age, due to the immense popularity of anime, both within Japan and overseas. Although not a commercial success, All About Lily Shushu directed by Shunji Iwai was honored at the Berlin, the Yokohama and the Shanghai Film Festivals in 2001. Takeshi Kitano appeared in Battle Royale and directed and starred in Dolls and Sadoichi. several horror films, Cairo, Dark Water, Yogan, The Grudge series and One Missed Call met with commercial success. In 2004, directed by Ryuhei Kitamura, was released to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Godzilla. In 2005, director Seijun Suzuki made his 56th film, Princess Raccoon. Hirokazu Koreeda claimed film festival awards around the world with two of his films Distance and Nobody Knows. Female film director Naomi Kawase's film The Morning Forest won the Grand Prix at the Cannes Film Festival in 2007. Yoji Imada, director of the Otoko Watsurayo series, made a trilogy of acclaimed revisionist samurai films, 2002's Twilight Samurai, followed by The Hidden Blade in 2004 and Love and Honor in 2006. In anime, Hayao Miyazaki directed Spirited Away in 2001, breaking Japanese box office records and winning several awards, including the Academy Award for Best Animated Feature in 2003, followed by Howl's Moving Castle and Ponyo in 2004 and 2008 respectively. In 2004, Mamoru Oshii released the anime movie which received critical praise around the world. His 2008 film The Skycrawlers was met with similarly positive international reception. Satoshi Kon also released three quieter, but nonetheless highly successful films, Millennium Actress, Tokyo Godfathers, and Paprika. Katsuhiro Otomo released Steam Boy, his first animated project since the 1995 short film compilation Memories, in 2004. In collaboration with Studio 4C, American director Michael Arias released Tekken Concrete in 2008. To international acclaim. After several years of directing primarily lower-key live-action films, Hideaki Anno formed his own production studio and revisited his still-popular Evangelion franchise with the rebuild of Evangelion Tetralogy, a new series of films providing an alternate retelling of the original story. In February 2000, the Japan Film Commission Promotion Council was established. On November 16, 2001, the Japanese Foundation for the Promotion of the Arts laws were presented to the House of Representatives. These laws were intended to promote the production of media arts, including film scenery, and stipulate that the government, on both the national and local levels, must lend aid in order to preserve film media. The laws were passed on November 30 and came into effect on December 7. In 2003, at a gathering for the Agency of Cultural Affairs, 12 policies were proposed in a written report to allow public-made films to be promoted and shown at the Film Center of the National Museum of Modern Art. 4 films have so far received international recognition by being selected to compete in major film festivals. Caterpillar by Koji Wakamatsu was in competition for the Golden Bear at the 60th Berlin International Film Festival and won the Silver Bear for Best Actress. Outrage by Takashi Kitano was in competition for the Palme d'Or at the 2010 Cannes Film Festival. Himizu by Sion Sono was in competition for the Golden Lion at the 68th Venice International Film Festival. In 2011, Takashi Mikes was in competition for the Palme d'Or at the 2012 Cannes Film Festival, the first 3D film ever to screen in competition at Cannes. The film was co-produced by British independent producer Jeremy Thomas, who had successfully broken Japanese titles such as Nagisa Oshima's Merry Christmas, Mr. Lawrence and Taboo, Takashi Kitano's brother, and Mike's 13 Assassins onto the international stage as producer. In 2018, Hirokazu Koreeda won the Palme d'Or for his movie Shoplifters at the 71st Cannes Film Festival. Genres of Japanese film include. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.